What's going on, Rainbow Six Siege fans? My name's Luke the Notable, and in this video, I'm going to be playing 100 games of ranked Rainbow Six Siege. Ubisoft actually sponsored this video. They wanted to see me try 100 games in ranked. They also want you to know about the new Rainbow Six Siege free weekend. Right now, with the Breach Into the Madness event, you can try out Rainbow Six Siege for free from March 5th to March 8th. You can also save up to 75% off if you purchase Rainbow Six Siege during the free weekend. That's March 5th to March 8th. And if at any point during this video you want to check out Rainbow Six Siege, go to the link in the description for more info. But now it's time for some ranked. Let's breach in to game number one. So this is it, game number one. And as you can see, I've got to play 10 games of ranked before I get a rank. So we're jumping right in. And you might notice that Rainbow Six Siege is a little bit different since the last time I played, especially in the ranked matches. Now at the start of every match, both teams will ban one operator, one offense, and one defense. For the entirety of the match, no one can use those operators. Everything else is pretty much the same. It's a game about offense and defense. Round one, I was playing Fuse. His ability is cluster charges that shoot grenades into the enemy's defenses. And of course, there's tons of different operators with different powers on offense and defense. Game one of round one, I was able to spray and pistol my way to 2 kills. But unfortunately, we ran out of time and there was one guy left on defense, so we lost the round. But now in round two, we're gonna be on offense again. That's another one of those changes I was talking about. You got 3 rounds of offense, 3 rounds of defense, and then if you're still tied after that, it goes back and forth up into 9 rounds. I know that sounds a little complicated, but I have 100 games to explain it to you, so I guarantee by the end of it, you'll understand. Oh, and we won round two. I didn't really help. No kills. All right, now we're game one, round three. We're still on offense, but next round will be on defense. I hope that explains things. This round, I played Blackbeard. He's got an amazing rifle and a ballistic shield to help against incoming fire, but that meant nothing because I got caught in a bear trap. Whatever, my team still won the round. I guess they didn't need me. All right, now it's round four. We played our 3 rounds of offense. Now we're playing our 3 rounds of defense. Though in theory, if we win the next 2 rounds, we'll win the entire match without even getting to round six. Just follow along. By the end of the video, you'll be an expert on this stuff. Round four, there were 4 of our guys left to the enemy team's 1. So I drew his fire, sacrificing myself, but winning the round. So because we've won 3 of the last 4 rounds, now it's the match point in round 5. If we win this one, the game's over. If the enemies want a chance, they have to win the next 2 to send it into overtime, so the ball is definitely in our court. I again played Tachanka, the greatest operator in the entire game, bar none. So of course, we won that round easily, and won the match. If you're still shaky on stuff, don't worry, I'll keep explaining, it's only game 1. But for now, you can just envy my awesome Tachanka skin. So of course, like before, game 2 is gonna start with banning of different operators for both teams. One offense, one defense. This time around, I'm starting off on the defensive team and we'll play 3 rounds of defense before switching to 3 rounds of offense. Though if every round goes as well as this one, we'll be done in 4. Yeah, it wasn't looking like we were gonna do too hot in this game. Round 2, we got killed pretty quickly too. Round 3 was going okay for a little bit. I got 1 kill, but then died like right after. Well, we lost all of our defensive rounds. I guess it's time for offense. All right, so now we're switching sides going into round 4 with 0 points, the enemy team having 3. If we want any chance of winning this game, we've got to win the next 3 rounds to send it into overtime. If we lose 1, the match is over. I had hope. I mean, anything's possible. They 3-0'd us, we could 3-0 them. But the enemy team was really thirsty for blood. They came outside and killed most of us. Last guy on our team was against 3 of the enemy team, and it went about as well as you might expect. Well, at least I got my first total defeat out of the way quickly. Game 3, round 5, we were down again. It was a 1v2 that I just turned into a 1v1. Remember, since the enemy team already has 3 points, if we lose this round, the game is over. There's a lot on my shoulders right now. I guess it was a good thing I had my favorite shotgun of all time, the M870, and it had a nice skin on it now. In game 3, I skipped ahead a little bit for the purpose of showing you how the overtime system works and to show you my awesome clutch here. So now it's 2-3 in round 6. If we win this one, it's 3-3, we're tied up and going to overtime. If the enemy team wins, they win. I died protecting the bomb. I'm a hero. So now we're in round 7, or overtime, where you basically just switch off back and forth between offense or defense for 3 rounds. Our team got offense first, but the footage is corrupted. Doesn't matter, because we lost. So in the next round, round 8, we switch over to defense, and if we lose this one, it's over. If we want to win, we've got to win the next 2. Everything was riding on this round, and I got shot without even knowing about it. Last guy on our team was up against 4 enemy players, and he tried. I'll give him that. Yeah, I think heartbreaking fits the description of that one. Game 4, our team was playing well. It was looking like we were going to win this one without having to go into overtime. Or so we thought. Yeah, game 4, we tied 3-3 in the first 6 rounds, so we're going into overtime. Just want to make sure you're paying attention. This overtime, we got defense first, so I'm playing Tachanka like a real man. I did okay for a while, but they had a Montang and I got taken down. We lost the first round of overtime, but that's fine. We still have 2 more rounds to prove ourselves. Now we're on offense, and I chose Dokkaebi because she's Kawhi. Though some guy killed me with a pistol before I even got in the building, which was definitely not Kawhi. Round 8 was going to come down to a 1v1, but even if we win this round, we still have to win 1 more to win the match. And hey, would you look at that? We won the round. It's going into round 9, a match that that goes to round 9 is the absolute epitome of rainbow fun. This is it. We've got to prove ourselves on defense. If we can win this round, we'll win the game. They had a Montang again. He always gives me the willies. Unfortunately, I got killed by a guy poking through a hole. In the end, though, it was a 2-1. Two of our guys against this Montang sitting on the bomb. But he was smart and ended up killing the dock that was defusing. Our guys prevailed, but we didn't have enough time to defuse the bomb, and we lost. I'm gonna have night terrors about that one for a long time. Game 5, I didn't do much, but thankfully I had a good team, and they handled it. Ranked was tough, man. You're going up against good players. Let your guard down for even a second, you're dead. But hey, you're not gonna get better at a game unless you play someone just as good or better than you. So hopefully by the end of these 100 games, I'll be good. Because at this point, my tactics mostly involve spraying and praying, but hey, sometimes that works out. See, we won game 5.
And I helped.
I've still got a long way to go, though. This is only game 6. I'm still not a confident man when it comes down to a 1-1. Oh, the other guy was way smarter, tracked me through the breakable wall and shot me. I was impressed. And I learned. I'll get there eventually. You're talking to the guy who's already played these 100 games and knows how it ends. But for now, all I'm good for is sitting in a corner and waiting until the team does most of the work. You know, guys, that corner I was sitting in was real safe. You're all very welcome. Hanging upside down with Blackbeard is one of my go-to strategies. You'd be surprised how often it works. And this time, sitting in the corner actually got me the round-ending kill, so who's the noob now? Round 3 of Game 7, I decided to try that Montang strategy from before. Simply plant the diffuser and then sit on it with all of your chunk. Yeah, that was pretty easy. I just sat there. No one could really touch me because I'm Montang, and we won. One guy on the enemy team was so impressed he tried it the next round with Montang. I'm gonna emphasize the word try in that statement. He did not succeed. That round, I got 3 kills and the round-ending kill, and I always love when that happens with an entry bomb. I was dead in the final round, but my soul was helping with the cameras, and we won. Guess who was the MVP? MV me. Game 8 was gonna come down to round 9, and I didn't really do anything too interesting in the other rounds, so might as well skip to this one. And I'm going with Jaeger's M870. There's no way we'll lose. I did absolutely nothing and we won. I got like 2 kills that entire game. Though game 9, my team was definitely not as good. It's a 1-5 now. And yeah, didn't last too long. Yeah, that one was bad. We got 0-4'd. Well, hopefully game 10 goes better. After this, I get a rank. The game will judge me. I played okay. Killed that guy laying down there on the right. But ultimately, it was another game of complete and total destruction for us. We didn't win a single round. It's gonna look real good on my permanent record. And after 10 games, I was ranked into Silver 2. Not terrible, not great. I'm okay with it. There's obviously a long way to go. I'd like to get gold by the end of this video. At least that's the goal. But we're not gonna get there unless I play. And in game 11, I played pretty well. X-rayed this guy for the round ender. I got a lot of kills this game, and thanks to that, we ended it pretty quickly in 4 rounds. Too bad you don't get any extra points for being the MVP, because I was. Haha. Oh wow, I'm actually really close to gold right now. All I have to do is not lose the next game. It was a tough one. I was going up against some guys with skins, so I knew they were good. We lost in overtime. I was very sad. But I hopped right back in game 13. As you can tell by the score, it wasn't going well, but I had hope. It was a 1-4, but at least I planted the diffuser, and now I'm hanging upside down as Blackbeard. So I'm invincible! Well, maybe I'm not invincible, but I did stall long enough to give my team some time and win the round. And thanks to some later bear trapping by yours truly, we have a chance in this one. Though I learned a very valuable trick with the claymore, only because I died by it. It's cool. Even without me, my team was able to get the win. And even in death, I was still the MVP. Again, one game away from gold. I can taste it. But then of course, I went on a 4-game losing streak. Well, this one only shows to round 3, but then the footage cuts out. So in just 4 short games, I went from the top of the silver rank to the absolute bottom. If I lose one more, I'm going down to bronze, and that's gonna hurt. Yeah, in game 18, I'm fighting all the way to round 9 for my privilege to stay in silver. I played hard. Like I said earlier, there's a lot at stake here. And in the end, I got 3 kills and the round ender to keep myself in silver. These games are definitely harder, but don't get me wrong, I'm enjoying every minute of it. You know, I'd probably be in gold already if I could play Tachanka every single round. I'm telling you, man, Tachanka's good. He doesn't need a buff. Round 4, I had to pee and was unfortunately kicked from the match. But what's really nice about Rainbow is you can join right back. It's easily one of my favorite features about ranked Rainbow Six Siege. Life happens, you know? Though honestly, I think this time it would have been better if I just stayed gone. Not like I helped or anything. I'm still Tachanking in game 20, and thanks to my expert immovable turret, we won the first 3 rounds. Unfortunately, because I can't play Tachanka on offense, I was confused and died upside down. My team handled it. I'm really not good until like game 50. I'll get there eventually, though, but until then, I'll be Tachanking it. Yeah, defense didn't go so well this game. We lost all 3 rounds. Game 21, there's very little footage of me actually alive because I died so quickly. Yeah, at least we got 1 round under our belt. We're skipping over to game 23 because game 22 is just straight up missing. I bought the elite skins for Frost and Blackbeard because they're probably my favorite operators on offense and defense. The elite skins are quite nice. I mean, look at that bear trap. It's menacing. When you buy an elite skin, you also get a matching gun skin, and I'm sure it helps with accuracy. I did buy Blackbeard's elite skin. I guess I just forgot to equip it. Well, I'm glad I lost this one in 4 rounds. Well, I'm in bronze now, and my shame is unimaginable. At least the competition ain't as steep. It wasn't a massive difference, but I did notice a little bit easier games when I went down to bronze. There is a rank under bronze. It's called copper. And if I were to get that low, I probably couldn't get up in the morning. Well, I guess it's good this game is going well then. I'm just trying to fight my way back up to silver. I was dead in the end, but we won. And technically, I tied for MVP. Game 25, I only have the recordings from overtime, but you know, that's all that really matters. Now it's a 1v1 and I'm in the bathroom. Oh no. I thought I could hear the clicking of the diffuser in the other room, and when I went over to investigate, I found the only other player in the match. And of course, shot him in the back. Not really sure what this piece of technology is, but I used it to win the round. Next round, I made my way in with Blackbeard and planted the diffuser. I got a little nervous when it went from a 5v1 to a 3v1 pretty quickly, but that didn't matter. We still won the game. Game 26 was going great, if only for this final kill cam. We were doing pretty well up 3-1, but then everything started going south. Yeah, we lost this one in overtime. Probably didn't help that I used predictable tactics. Oh, game 27. Yeah, just great. It was going fantastic. Despite my performance in the earlier rounds, though, when it mattered most in round 9, I clutched up. And in the end, yes, it was a little bit sloppy, but I got the final kill. Gave him a couple extra just to make sure. Game 28, I didn't do anything notable until we were already down 2 points. But hey, at least we didn't lose the first 3 rounds. It's hard to come back from that. From there, our team won 3 in a row, and with some nice off-screen bear trapping, it looks like we might win the game. It was a 2v2 until this player crouch walked in front of me and I shot him in the back of the head. Last guy on the enemy team didn't even try us. He let the clock run out and we won the match. I had no idea Elite Skins had a special animation for getting MVP, but now I need more. I played pretty well game 29. Got a lot of kills, but not when it mattered most. But in this game, sometimes it doesn't matter how many people you kill. If the enemies play the objective and play it right, you're gonna lose. And I'll be the first to admit, I'm not the best at this game. I mean, I'm in bronze right now. What do you expect? But I'm learning a ton playing ranked, and by the end of these 100 games, you'll see that I'm a night and day different player. But there's still a ton to learn. I mean, I'm still getting caught in bear traps. Oh, that's great. The final kill cam is just me slowly dying from a bear trap. Awesome. Game 31, I found a way to plant the diffuser again. I'm just good at it with Blackbeard. Too bad I was suffering from stage 4 bulletitis and got killed pretty quickly. I'm not sure what happened after that, but we won! Round 1 was pretty much the only good luck we had that game, though. I mean, we never stopped trying, but you can just tell by these kill cams. The other guys, they were good. I'm playing a little better too here, though. It helps that I'm in bronze. Round 5, I was in the bathroom during the operator picking part of the match. I was pushing hard. I was back for the robot phase. Doubt I washed my hands. I played Thatcher, who I really don't play a whole lot. I don't even have a sight on my gun, but I'm a real recruity man and don't need no sight.
Oh, hello. How are you today, sir?
Match point, I'm Blackbeard, and I got caught sneaking in the woman's locker room. This guy and our team killed most of them. I wasn't needed. Game 33, I was playing okay. The team was still losing horribly. This is my corner. No one's getting through. Hey, at least they won't beat us completely here. Still, since they won the first 3 rounds, we gotta win our first 3 rounds. Lose one and it's over. And that's kinda looking like what's gonna happen. Yeah, see, there it is. Things weren't going great in game 34 either.
Oh no,
Chunkums! I knew the second T'Chunk had died, we were gonna lose that one. I've been playing a lot of Legion on defense, mostly when someone takes Frost. I love his little needle power. I love his shotgun. He's a great operator. He's also got impact grenades. I use them mostly for taunting. Later on, played Habana just to prove that I know this isn't a grenade launcher. It blows through walls. I'm smart now. My only regret is I was MVP and should have played Blackbeard to see his animation. You know the game isn't going well when you've barely got to the house and it's already a 2v4. I know earlier I said bronze was easier, but I seem to be getting killed a lot here. Maybe I'm just bad. Yeah, maybe if I could aim, I would have lived in game 37. Everyone's telling me to use the ACOG, but I don't know. I think I just shoot better with the red dot. But I definitely shoot best when I'm up close with a shotgun. And in this game, I was able to use my shotgun to clutch out the win for the team. Game 38, I was playing Montang, having a great time, but not doing well. Whatever, I'm better with a gun, even if I'm not a big fan of the ACOG. Like I said, I'm shooting better, a little. Still not winning, you can check the score. Game 39 was already very dishonorable. We had guys coming outside. I dispensed justice. Pretty even match, though. We were all just a bunch of bronzy boys. You know, I'll bet you see kill cams like this in the champion division. This time around, I got the last kill of the game with Old Reliable. The M870. Game 40 was going good. My enemies were perishing before me. My head was hurting really bad, but I'm still planting that diffuser. Oh yeah, thanks to my diffusing, we won round 1. But that means nothing! I mean, you never know, man. Sometimes explosive hockey pucks come through the wall and kill you. It was looking like we were about to wrap up game 40. I just killed the last guy. But no one could find the diffuser, and we lost. That was a tough one. That's okay, we defended the same location the next round and played a little better. I got a kill, and we won the game. What more can you ask for? Game 41, I decided to hide the diffuser inside the body of the enemy. I'm sure he won't mind. 1v1, and all I had to do was stop the last guy from diffusing. Just ran up and rushed him because he was hiding in the corner and we lost the round. I'm so ashamed. Oh well, I'll feel better after some T'Chunking. Don't shoot the turret outside like I just did. It doesn't work. And I'm telling you, one of these days I'll get good at poking through little holes, but I'm still pretty bad at it. Wow, game 42 is going great. I wonder what could possibly make this worse. Sure, I lost the round, but this final kill cam is quite priceless. Yeah, and I know it was looking bad, but at least we didn't lose the first three rounds. We got it into overtime, but now it's 3-1 against Montang, and he didn't make it. I guess there's still a little hope, right, guys?
No.
Game 43, most of the action happened in the first round, and I'm really not sure how that guy didn't see me. Must be this elite skin I have for Frost. And with some more expert accuracy, we won the first round. And with my newfound ability to shoot through walls, we should have no problem winning the rest. Like I said, most of the action was in the first round for me, but we still won all four for a flawless victory. I was close to MVP, but didn't cut it. Game 44, I'm still putting good energy in that shooting through wall style. Sometimes you can get some real sneaky kills. These games have been tough, but I've been learning every step of the way, and I think by this point it's time for me to get out of bronze. And thanks to this guy on my team who pulled off a nice round-ending triple kill, I'm one step closer. Just gotta win the next game and I'll be there. But I don't know how I'm gonna do it without Blackbeard. He got banned game 45. Well, we played defense first, so I had to play Frost, and things were going well. Round 2, someone chose Frost, so I picked Legion, ran outside to get a kill, and got what I deserved. Listen, I know there was a lot on the line, but in the final round, I played Glass for a challenge. Figured I could get Silver and some more renown. And there we are, back to Silver, feeling good. Game 46 was going into overtime. Good thing I got to choose Frost. I didn't really do anything, was just roaming the halls of the bank when we won. But you know how this works, we still gotta beat them on offense to clutch the victory. There may have been a brief moment of teammate-on-teammate action, but we still won the round and the match, so it's all good. Game 47 was ending in overtime too, this time round 9. And with the game on the line, I shot my teammate. Though really, that one was not my fault. I made up for it, killed a couple other guys on the enemy team before dying myself. That's okay, this guy on our team planted the diffuser and then denied a diffusee to win the game. Game 48 was a tough one, but we came ready to play. It was tied 2-2 in round 4. Though in round 5, Amira was absolutely locking down the objective. We could not get in. And with almost no time, I ran in, and you know that never works. Sometimes this game is just decided by pixels. Here, if I shot a little bit more accurately, maybe we could have won. But of course, we didn't. Game 49 was one of those games where if you turned your back for just a brief second, you'd probably end up dead. Despite some early losses, the team was able to hold it together and get it to overtime. Round 7, I was left in a 1-3 situation, and in the end, I didn't die. But we didn't win the round, so I felt like dying. And all it took to put us away in this one was a couple of hockey pucks. Every defeat is a heartbreaking defeat. Game 50, I decided to shoot my gun in the air to intimidate the other team. It didn't work. Not at all. Later on, I was playing Mira on defense. I'm in the market for more elite skins, and she's a great operator. This game, I was playing Mira when it mattered most in a 1-1 situation for the match point. I saw exactly when the enemy was planting the diffuser, and I inaccurately but effectively shot him to win the round. And the game. Mira's also got an exceptionally cool elite skin. I really like this thing. Of course, and you know game 51, I'm breaking it in. I think I need some practice though, because I'm really not sure how I allowed that guy to do that to me. Well, hopefully we can send it into overtime with this diffuser plant. Too bad I shot so poorly I rolled over in my own grave. Then the same guy that killed me diffused. Awesome. And you can just tell by the score, game 52 ain't going great. I also just flashed myself. You win some, you lose some, and sometimes you're embarrassed publicly in front of millions. Game 53 was the opposite though. 3-1, round 4, match point. The other guy flashed me, but he hesitated, so when he came through the door, I was ready to blast him. Good, I was getting close to bronze there. Yeah, that's an insta-cop. Now we're playing a little Capitao on offense. His guns are amazing and he shoots fire. What more do you want? Now I've wasted 3 on the team. And there's 4. Pushed in looking for the 5th guy and it was a cap can who killed me. I killed 4 of them, but we still lost the round. Next round wasn't looking good either. Now I'm playing Mira in the match point. Magically. Last guy was a Blackbeard without an elite skin, so it was an easy kill. Game 55, again, we're clutching up with Mira. I wasn't even using mirrors, I was using a bunk bed. It was a 2-1 that I negotiated down to a 1-1. My dead family helped me with the cameras, so I knew exactly when to push out and win the game. It's all gonna come down to round 9 in game 56. Played Cap Can, cause I can. And some guy who's obviously way better totally destroyed me. At least my soul will live on through a bulletproof camera, so I'll never truly die. I'm realizing I should have done this at game 50, but here's my stats up into game 57. What's interesting is right now we've got a 50-50 win rate. I'll take it, especially for my first ranked season, but I still got a ways to go. Cause even in silver, you can't let people catch you sleeping. Yeah, and after watching this kill cam, I knew I deserved to lose that match. Game 58 was a pretty even game. I mean, I've died like this a couple times so far already. Going in match point with Capitao, mostly just looking for a fire kill. 1-2 here, and I just got a pulse not paying attention. 1-1 game on the line, and I used my golden gun to get the final kill. If a player steps on a bear trap and no one is there to it. Does he still rage quit? This video is dedicated to the guy that had 2 HP and stepped on a cage trap for our victory. Alright, overtime match point. Really should have played Mira. Fireball! We played well and defeated them, as I was bravely holding up the rear. Game 60, round 1. I'm not even mad. Look at this grenade. It's beautiful! And later, the most beautiful of kill cams happened. We did it! But I didn't make it. Game 61, we were doing pretty well, mostly because because I was playing Tachanka. And this time I didn't even need my turret, it was mostly shotgun kills. But the game didn't go well the whole time, now it's match point, we're down and it's a 1v2. I got as far as the bomb location with the diffuser, but got caught reloading. I finally learned how to use the noob detector in game 62, but unfortunately I don't have a lot of experience with the noob deleter. You know, they should really put a gun on the end of this thing. Just a little one. Round 4, match point, and I'm playing Montang. The enemy was very happy to see me. Had the perfect Montang defusal plant. I was ready to sit on this thing until we won. And we won quickly. Having a good game 63. I always like using the Deagle. I was feeling pretty accurate too. Ended this one with one clean shot. Didn't matter though, cause some guy on the enemy team was shooting way better. Oh well, back to business in game 64. Match on the line and I forgot a sight on my gun. I really deserve to be here. This is it. 2v2 and my teammate just went down. Ran in spraying and got a lucky headshot. Wasn't as lucky with the second guy, but when I pulled out my pistol to kill him, he turned around and I got the easy kill. This time I was the most notable player. I'm gonna get over with game 65 quickly, mostly for respect to the other team. One of our guys got an ace round one. I got a couple kills too, but nowhere near ace level. Needless to say, it was looking like we were gonna win this one in 4 rounds, so I went outside to finish the job. Game 66 was going great. Round one, I got myself a double kill, but I didn't realize a teammate was blocking me from getting through the door until it was too late. This one's coming down to overtime. It was a tight game. They played well. We tried to defuse. We just simply didn't have enough time. Definitely didn't want to lose this one. Too bad I died first. This guy was mourning me when he got shot. It was over very quickly after that. No cap, playing Capitao, game 67. If you're gonna be shooting outside and have a claymore, always put one near an exterior door. Some guy tried to come out and shoot us, but thanks to the claymore, we were safe. We were in the process of smoke defusing when we got the victory. Rest of the game went well, even though I died a bunch. The team handled it this round, showing no fear and getting the win. Oh yeah, getting some good stuff on game 68. That's for Mira. Playing Bank though, and I don't know how to use Mira on Bank, so I chose Legion. It didn't exactly go great. We lost the first 3 defensive rounds. But you know, it's probably a good thing this game's over quick, because the next one's a good one. Now it's game 69, and I made sure to bring my latex gloves. Ah, it's a 1v3. Good thing I got the good stuff. This is why I don't play Doc. I'm always distracted with healing myself. Later at a fair 1v1 with Blackbeard and redeemed myself. Very next round, I got the last kill too. It was a thick old chunk of us coming through the door. The last round, I didn't really do anything. Yep, didn't even enter the house, and we won the game. Game 70, we won the first round, but that was all the rounds we won. We got absolutely demolished in the rest. I got headshotted through a Blackbeard shield. They were just better. Early game 71, I planted the diffuser, but I was playing Fuse, and his shield is nowhere near as big as Montang's. I've got Fuse and Capcan Elite skins now, so I'm always gold. Using my excellent sense of fashion, I was able to win round 4 for my team. The team and I played well all around, and we won that one in round 5. I was just trying to set up one of my traps in game 72. This guy didn't have to shoot me. I was pretty useless this whole game, but at least I looked cool, right? I shot a lot of hockey pucks in this one, only killing a couple of gadgets, but we still won. We lost the first 3 rounds of game 73, but as long as I've got Blackbeard, I've got hope. Not gonna beat me in 4, at least not this time. You could definitely beat me in 5 though, I get beat all the time in 5. Came back though, game 74, we're looking to beat these guys in 4. Well, that's not gonna help. My team did let me sit there and bleed for a while. That's fine, cause they were just busy winning the game. I helped, no one stepped on that bear trap because of me. Tough guys in game 75 though, they were coming outside a ton. You know, Blackbeard's pretty good, but his shield won't help against fire. Maybe I'll get a little luckier with Capitao. Capitao's great. You get a little fire, a little smoke. Game 75 was pretty much just a whole game of disappointments. Right before game 76, I bought myself the battle pass and got a ton of alpha packs. Ah, now it's a 1v3. The diffuser's planted and things are on fire. Oh, now I'm dead. Later, I got shot outside. It's so preventable. Why do I do this? Match point and I'm very overdressed. I went down very easy. Hardly made a sound. And just 20 seconds later, the entire squad was dead and we were the losers. It's game 77 and I still haven't killed anyone with fire yet, so I'm trying here. I was sitting there patiently camping the diffuser when my team won the round. I didn't even know this angle was a thing until now, but I'm gonna use it for sure. See, look at me, I'm learning all the tricks. 1v1 to stay in the game, and I shot the other guy, but didn't kill him. 78 and 79 are both missing, so we're gonna switch right over to game 80. Round 1, I was playing Glass for a challenge, and it totally showed. Round 2, I was playing Ash. I can't remember why, but it turned out to be a good decision, because I got a couple kills. Round 3, I even stopped a guy trying to come outside. Served him right. I even got one of his friends. I was just sneaking around looking for my next victim when we won that round. The team fell on hard times in round 4 though, and I was the last one to die. 1v3 in the next round, but at least it just turned into a 1v2. Even if I killed him, I still would have had to defuse. Alright, we gotta win this one or it's over, but I'm playing Frost so my odds are pretty good. I didn't get any kills. I soaked up some bullets, I guess. Still, none of us died, and now we're going to overtime. I played Fuse with the shield again, and I probably should have gone in before my teammate there. Though I'm really not sure how that would have been much better. I'm not great with this shield. Alright, we lost that one, sure, but if we win the next 2, we could win the game. Let's do it. And I was the first one to die again. I tried to help with the cameras, but it was all for naught. And even though game 81 was off to a bad start too, I still got some kills with Fuse. I was even able to get a kill with Fuse's explosive power, which just always feels nice. We rallied tallied a couple points in this one, tying the match up 2-2 in round 4. But with the match on the line, even though I got a little lucky with that headshot, we still lost. Sledge is becoming one of my favorite operators. It's just fun to hammer. And once I figured out you can hammer most of the surfaces in the game, I was hooked. And it's not just hammering for hammering's sake. Here I can protect the diffuser from above. We won. You're welcome. I wasn't kidding about being addicted to hammering. It doesn't help that it gives me 5 points every time. Round 3, I did nothing but hammering. And we won. There's something to this. I'm also dabbling with some Echo on defense. He's great, even though this footage doesn't really show that. He's got invisible camera drones, so even if you die, you can help your team win, like I did here. Echo's one of those operators I put on when I'm not really sure who else to use. I mean, there are many situations that can't be helped with an invisible camera. Oh, you know what else is good in any situation? A hammer! Well, maybe not this time. Hammer or not, when the game's on the line, I'm going Blackbeard. And thanks to me and my Blackbeard, this time we're going to overtime. Ah, would you look at that. Game's on the line with Blackbeard again. At least I didn't get shot while hanging upside down. Well, the second guy that came outside killed me. I felt that one in my spleen more, but maybe that's just me. Game 84 started great. We dominated in the first round. We were down a match, so I evoked the power of the turret. Ah, 1v3. An even fight for Tachanka. I almost got one. If only I could pick my turret up and shoot it on the move. Next round, another 1v3 with the Tachanka. And it was weird. He didn't clutch it up either. Game 85, 1v2, and I'm playing Echo. First guy was disoriented, so he went down pretty easy. I missed the first spray on the second guy, but got him with my pistol. Where is it? Found the diffuser. Diffused it. No need to panic. All right, now it's a 1v5. Better make sure this thing's full. I don't remember much. I blacked out. Got it down to a 1v2. I had the hope of winning the round that was crushed almost immediately when someone shot me. The next round, I was just trying to get the diffuser off the ground, but I ended up in a pile of my own teammates. Now I see exactly why we lost. There was no point in even trying. Game 86 started off bad, but that's fine. I had Legion's Elite. Yo, check the new drip. Admittedly, I was a little flicker in a camera for most of this one. I tried to tell my guy they were right there, but he didn't listen, and we lost. Match point, playing Cali. I don't know. Might as well shake it up a bit. It was bad. Never used the sniper. Couldn't even use my pistol. Just bad. Playing Clash Game 87, she's banned pretty much every time and for really good reason. She's a defensive Montang with a taser shield. Unstoppable. For the record, I voted to ban Clash this game. We could have prevented this. This was a very good game for me. Round 2, I started killing and just couldn't stop. And when I killed the fourth player here, I was thinking an ace was possible. But I ran outside because I'm greedy and got what I deserved. It was looking like we were gonna put him away in 4 rounds. But we didn't. And now somehow it's round 9 overtime. We had these guys. Great finish. I used the same angle as before to get the final kill. I was the MVP, but I kind of regretted using Frost again. I went right back to hammering in game 88. Maybe I should cut back on the hammering. It almost got me killed here. Well, obviously, there's no limit on celebratory hammering. This one was gonna end in another round 9. My heart can't take this. I got taken down, but at least I looked good doing it. We won. We defused the bomb. Hooray! Game 89 was amazing, and that's all I have to say. Game 90, we've got audio, but no video. I'm gonna fire my AV guy, who's me. And everything was going great in game 91 until it totally wasn't. 92 was a total defeat, and I'm gonna skip it for my public image. Game 93, my claymore got us into round 9. Yes, I did it! I'm the hero! Round 9 defense, I played Mira. If I could play well enough, I was in line for MVP. And with Mira's MVP animation on the line, I won this game easily, even getting the last kill. She's got a huge gun! Like, look at that thing! Yes! This was worth every penny. I'd say game 94 was pretty explosive. I'm playing Cali again, and got a chance to use the sniper rifle. It's great. I shot pretty well and got it down to a 2v1 in the match point. But when it got down to a 1v1, I couldn't make it happen. Next round, I played Cali again, and made a complete fool of myself. We won though, last guy shot Montang, and then our guy got him. I was starting off game 95 right, clutching up the 1v2 in round 1. Round 2, I got the diffuser plant, and we defended easy. The good luck didn't stay all game, we were gonna have to fight for this win. 3 seconds on the clock left, all I gotta do is run out the time, but the enemy team was defusing, so they got an extension. So now it's a 1v1, and if you listen close, you can hear my bear trap get him. Well, Rook got him, but I helped. Then he did the thing, and we won. I went right back to losing in game 96. Total defeat. I tried in game 97, and that's all that matters. And I'm gonna need some time before I can speak about game 98. Got to see Blackbeard's MVP animation in game 99. Too bad it wasn't me. Game 100's gotta be a good one, because I'm one bad game away from being back in bronze. Try not to let my losing streak deceive you. I'm much better at Siege now. Not great, but a lot better than when I started. There's a lot of tactics in Siege. It takes a long time to learn them all. And I think 100 games was the perfect amount of time to learn something. Maybe not everything, but something. And I also found a lot of new love for a lot of the operators in the game. I spent the entirety of round 4 in Echo's drone. If you've never played ranked Siege before, go do it. But be careful, you might run into me. And I got bear traps. And one last time in game 100, I protected my corner. Got the victory. But most importantly, stayed out of bronze. So here it is, my final stats after 100 games of ranked Rainbow Six Siege. 48 wins, 52 losses, but a 1.0 KD. No abandons.
Not once.
Gotta mention the sizable amount of in-game currency. I think I did pretty well. Never got to gold, but at least I didn't get back down to bronze. You get a gun charm that correlates to your rank, so I'm definitely in next season. But that's it for the games. If you like what you saw, make sure to check out Rainbow Six Siege. If you're watching this video when it's fresh, you can try it for free. And remember, if you purchase Rainbow Six Siege during the free weekend, you can save up to 75% off. If you'd like to learn more about how you can play Rainbow Six Siege for free, make sure to click the link in the description. Click that link and breach into the madness, March 5th to March 8th. It's free, but that's it for the video. I hope you learned something, or at the very least enjoyed it. I know I did. Thank you to Ubisoft for sponsoring this video, and thank you to you for watching. Stay notable. I'll see you in the next one.